Well, the inflation numbers were just released and they are coming down and coming down dramatically. So my name is Dan Frio. I do this rate report every day to inform you guys what's going on in real estate, what's going on with prices, what's going on with interest rates. Are there any fantastic programs out there available for you guys? So what we're going to talk about today is the inflation number, because we've all been sitting on the sidelines just waiting for this number to come in saying, please inflation cool down, please cool down. And it's plummeting. So here's a chart that you're seeing right now. If you go over to this, sorry about my mic. If you go over here, a year ago, the inflation rate was 9.1? Hold on, I got to put on my cheaters. 9.1. Where are we today? 3. So are we coming down? You betcha we're coming down by the efforts of the Federal Reserve. They're killing everything right now. But let's get over to the economic calendar, see how good these numbers really were. So what you're seeing on your screen is the economic calendar for today. And as if you notice, 3 of the 4 features are basically inflation numbers. The CPI is the inflation rate at the consumer level. So let's go through these. There's a core CPI month over month. And then there's a CPI YOY, that means year over year. And then there's a CPI MON, means month over month. What the core CPI is basically, it's the main CPI number. So what the CPI is, the consumer inflation index, and it's a basket of goods and services. There's food, there's shelter, there's insurances, there's healthcare, there's cars, there's all this other stuff that you and I consume on a daily basis. And they do this analysis. They do it month over month and year over year. So what you're seeing here is the core CPI, it strips out food and energy. Why? Because it's hugely volatile. It goes day by day like this. It's not like housing that's, you know, goes like this or whatever else. Gas prices, it's as you guys follow my channel, it's one of my pet peeves. You know, I drive to work one morning, it's $3. I drive home that night and it's $3.50. I've never seen that in my whole lifetime. So this is what you're seeing right now. The core CPI, the last reading came in at 0.4. Analysts were saying it should come in at 0.3. It came in at 0.2. Okay, so lower than expectations. Then you have the CPI year over year. This is the big number. They're saying, okay, how much has inflation gone since last June to this June? Well, the last reading was 4%. Expectations were 3.1. If you watched my video yesterday, I said, we might teeter on that. It might, we might not hit this number yet, but we're gonna be there. We're probably gonna be in the twos in the next 60 to 90 days. Well, we're almost there, folks. You're gonna see the CPI year over year dramatically dropped from where we were over here at 9% all the way down to 3%. So we're on a huge trajectory down. And then we have CPI month over month. The last reading was 0.1. They thought it was a complete anomaly. So they're like, we're going to raise it to 0.3. It came in at 0.2. Nothing but good data here. And then when you go over to here, here's one thing that's really, I guess, encouraging is the index for shelter was the largest contributor to the monthly's overall increase, accounting for 70% of the increase. So just think, when the Federal Reserve's numbers actually get updated on the shelter piece, if this shelter piece is 70% of the CPI number, what happens when they actually adjust it and this number is down probably about 8%? These numbers, their inflation numbers, are going to be in the twos really quick. So let's go over to the headlines that we're seeing. Home prices continually hit record highs. So here's something I want to discuss. The housing crash. Everybody's like, the housing market's going to crash, going to crash, going to crash. Guys, it did. We're in a crash. But we're not seeing crashes in values. We're not seeing it in the value of homes. We're seeing it in the units. The number of units is dramatically down. You could ask me. You could ask any realtor. We're not seeing price crashes in most parts of the US, and it's confirmed right here, because think of it this way. There's nothing out there to buy. My neighborhood consists of probably about 200 to 300 homes. There's 2 homes on the market, 1 just sold for the asking price. Okay. And it's in an upper middle class neighborhood. So it's not, you know, $100,000 or $200,000 home. And it's sold in a matter of about a week and a half. So why? There's no supply. And people, if you want to live in that neighborhood, you have to buy one of 2 houses available. So what happens? It causes people to compete on that limited house number of units available, driving up the price, or at least stabilizing the prices. Now, a lot of people are saying, Dan, nobody has any money. Well, I'm going to counter you a little bit on there. I've proven that the consumer disposable income is way off the charts. It's really high. The M2 money supply is how much money people have in the bank and short-term and liquidity assets. And it's still at a record high. It's about 5 times where we were about 10 years ago. So there is still a lot of money in the system. Last night, me and my family, we went down and played trivia at some bar in my town. It was packed. On a Tuesday night. So we're going down through town. Every restaurant's packed. Every venue's packed. The bars are packed. It's a Tuesday night, folks. So here's my thought on all this is people went through COVID. They were stuck in their homes. Okay. So they bought stuff. Why do you think Peloton stock skyrocketed? Now they're plummeting because people were just buying stuff with the money that they had because they couldn't go outside. Now they got all the stuff they want. So now they're enjoying life. Look at the airlines. Airlines have record numbers of people traveling. You know, look at restaurants, look at everything else. Look at the service sector, service and leisure. The numbers are going out the roof. People are now moving over to just enjoying life a little bit. So there is money out there. You just have to be prudent on where you're looking to live. And is it a prudent decision to rent or buy? I don't know. Only you guys can make that decision. So based on this information that we have today, just the CPI numbers, what's going on with mortgage rates? Well, here's the top six mortgage products or mortgage rates that people use when they're buying or refinancing a house. This is issued by Mortgage News Daily. There's a delay. This is actually where the market closed yesterday. But let me give you an idea where we're going from here. So the first thing we want to look at is what the Federal Reserve is going to do at the next meeting. Now, they're meeting in 14 days, 2 hours, and 27 minutes and 37 seconds. That's when the Federal Reserve is meeting next. What are they going to tell us, or what does this gauge tell us that we're looking at? Well, this is telling us what is the likelihood that the Federal Reserve will change the federal funds target rate at the next meeting. Well, right now, the federal funds rate is 5.25. What's the numbers look like right now? Well, I don't think those numbers are really going to change. There's still over 90% of a probability that the Federal Reserve is going to raise rates at the next meeting. But now these numbers are starting to come down. This was over a 33% or 35% yesterday. Now this is down to 12 and this is at 25. So we're looking at maybe one more adjustment from the Fed and then all bets are off at that point. I don't think they're going to do anything from there because I'm still saying our inflation numbers, even the next reading is going to come down in the mid twos. And then the Federal Reserve is going to be like, okay, we like where things are going here. So the next thing we want to look at is where the bond market, what's going on in the bond markets and the stock market based on this information? Well, the bond market's loving it. Let's get over to the stock market first. So we go to CNBC. We'll just hit the clicker right there. Dow Jones up more than 200 points after lighter than expected inflation numbers. So the markets are liking this all over the board. Stock market, S&P, NASDAQ, the Russell 2000, everything is liking it. Bond market, let's get over there and see what it's doing. So what you're seeing on your screen right now is the mortgage-backed security bond. You're seeing it right in the middle of your screen, right up through here. Okay, what you're seeing, if you squint, you can see behind that 97.91 right next to it, it says plus 69. What does this mean? So what the MBS is a bond that trades on Wall Street that's yield is the biggest factor of your mortgage rate because it's a mortgage bond. All right. Right now we're seeing this. If you squint, the market is up 69 ticks. So meaning the price is up 0.69. All you need to know is if the number is up, rates come down. If the number goes down, rates go up. There's a yin yang or a flip flop relationship. Right now we're seeing the MBS market almost up 70 bips. That's probably going to be about an eighth to a quarter reduction in rates today. So how do you figure out, you know, can you find a house? Can you buy a house? Can you qualify for a house? Well, we'd love to talk to you. My name is Dan Freo. I do this report every day. I'm a mortgage advisor and have been doing it for over 30 years. How do you reach out to us? Well, there's best ways to get started on this. First thing is, if you want to give us a call, 844-775-5626. That's how you can give us a call. Or if you're like, Dan, I need help. Can I afford a house? Can I buy a house? What's my budget look like? Well, to get started, all I need you to do is fill out the application right here. Just click the apply now button. You're going to ask a few questions. From there, a mortgage advisor will be with you within 24 hours to go over any questions with you and all the programs available that you might qualify for. So thank you so much for watching today's video. God bless. And if you would, please do me one favor, give me a thumbs up. I'd appreciate it. Take care, guys. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.